Hey there! Have you ever wondered how a few simple changes such as reduce, reuse and recycle can make a huge difference for our planet? Well, in that case you're at the right place. In this video we're exploring the 10 R's of sustainability, an essential guide to help you cut down your carbon footprint, conserve resources and protect the Earth for generations to come. Are you ready? Let's go! R0, refuse. Refuse is simple and straightforward. Say no to unnecessary stuff. If you don't need it, don't buy it. Whether it's plastic straws, fast fashion, or those small items that end up cluttering landfills, the goal is simple. Refuse single-use products and make conscious choices. R1, Rethink. Rethink is focused on changing the way we approach our daily habits. Can we use more sustainable energy, retrieved from wind, solar or water? Or could we consider alternatives to driving, like walking, cycling or public transit? It's all about being intentional with the choices we make every day. R2, reduce. Reduce is about minimizing waste and being more conscious of our consumption. Try to use less of everything, from water and electricity to the materials we lean on in our daily routines, such as food, clothes and electronics. The idea is simple. The less we consume, the less waste we create. R3, reuse. Reuse encourages us to repurpose items instead of throwing them away. Whether it's reusing jars for storage, donating old clothes or turning old pallets into furniture, it's all about giving things a second life. R4, repair. Repair is about fixing stuff instead of discarding them when they break. How often do we replace gadgets such as a computer when a simple repair could extend their life? By choosing to repair rather than replace, you save money, reduce waste and help to keep more items out of landfills. It's a win for both your wallet and the planet. R5, refurbish. Refurbish takes repair to the next level. Instead of buying brand new items, consider refurbishing or restoring items such as old furniture. For example, rather than tossing out an old table, you can have it refurbished to work like new again. This process often involves cleaning, upgrading parts and fixing small issues. R6, recreate. Recreate encourages us to transform used materials or products into something entirely new. For example, old car parts, electronics or even clothing can be remade into valuable products, such as refurbished engines, computers or stylish bags. R7, repurpose. Repurpose is all about getting creative and thinking outside the box. Instead of tossing out old items, why not transform them into something new and useful? For example, you can use wooden pallets to craft your own compost bins, tin cans as pencil holder, or glass jars as storage containers for spices, herbs and pasta. R8, recycle. Recycle is one of the most well-known and essential steps in sustainability. It plays a crucial role in reducing the amount of waste that ends up in landfills. By recycling materials like paper, glass, plastic, wood, and metal, we are able to reduce greenhouse gas emissions, the need for raw materials, and energy consumption associated with manufacturing new goods. R9, recover. Recover is focused on extracting energy or valuable materials from waste. For example, organic waste can be turned into nutrition-rich compost, or energy can be generated from trash through processes like waste-to-energy systems. It goes beyond recycling by ensuring that nothing is truly wasted. As we've seen today, the 10 R's of sustainability are all essential steps towards a more sustainable world. The great thing is you don't have to do everything at once. Start with one and build from there. Every small change adds up, and together we can make a real difference for the planet. If you found this video informative, please give it a like and share your thoughts on reduce, reuse and recycle in the comments below. If you would like to know more about sustainability in general, please hit that subscribe button and check out the other videos on my channel. Thanks for watching and see you next time.